Hello. Okay, so I today am starting this unofficial, or I guess we could call it official, unscientific trombone rating system, because all the different brands have different things they can offer, and different explanations for why the different trombones sound different. But comparing them is really kind of hard, unless you're sitting and playing them back to back, which often you're not. In fact, most of the time, none of us are. So I wanted to start doing that. And so I have a bunch of specifications about, you know, what makes a trombone different from one another. And so far, I only have the trombones that I have played. And so if you have a trombone in mind, or a manufacturer of trombone, a certain kind of certain brand of trombone that you want to see on this list, comment below. I'll reach out to that company and we'll see what we can do. This is an exciting thing that we couldn't do when we were working with Consulmer, and so I want to get cracking at it. And so the first thing that we will look at is price. And so we have six trombones here. I've never played the Amun and I've never played the DeCarbo, all the way on the left and the right, the least expensive and the most. The Amun is the infamous world's cheapest trombone as rated and reviewed by Trent Hamilton. And the DeCarbo is just the most expensive trombone I could find that is new. I mean, there's probably, or maybe not probably, but potentially a trombone out there that is a vintage or a collector's item that would sell for more than that. But as far as new trombones that you can buy today, that seemed to be like the most expensive as far as tenor trombones go. Those are really just there for scale. And then I have these four trombones that I have played. Again, these are just tenors for now. And so we have the P-Bone at $179. That is the most trombone you can get for that money. I would say the Amun is something that you should never consider, but the P-Bone, great trombone for the money. The BAC, this is a new trombone that I've been trying out. This is the Kansas City Artist Series model. And so that's a trombone I just picked up at the American Trombone Workshop last week. And so we are fitting that into this list as well. That is $2,100. Now the vintage King 2B that you've seen in all my videos playing lead and all that stuff, that's, I have it on there for $2,500. You can find it for cheaper if it's not in good condition or the person doesn't know what it is. You can find it for more expensive if it's in great condition and the person knows exactly what it is. And so, I have it around there. The new models that they're making today, the King 2Bs are $2,129. So around there. Now my Bach 42T with the TheraValve that I bought in high school, that was $32.69, I guess, and they're running about there now for the Bach Stradivarius 42s, and so that's kind of your range of trombone. Usually the ones with the valves are going to be more expensive because there's more tubing and it's more metal. It's just more resources to make it, so keep that in mind. Now, let's move on to something a little bit more specific, the bell size. The King 2B has 7.25 inch bell, all the way to the Bach 42T with the 8.5. This is no surprise to anybody. The smaller trombones, smaller bell, bigger trombones, bigger bell. Done. Okay. Tone quality. Now, this is something that's a little bit more exciting to talk about. On the left, we have the brightest tone, and the right, we have the darkest. Now, this is not going to be a surprise to anybody who knows these trombones, but I think as we put new trombones in, it'll actually be really fun to see how they stack up against each other, because this isn't, you know, a scale where you rate something like, this is, you know, this gets a 5 out of 10 for, you know, darkness, you know, something that we try to pretend is objective when really it's still subjective. And so what I want to do is kind of, for me, put them in an order that makes sense and that I think is accurate. And then you can use that to just kind of, you know, work around like, oh, I really love this BAC, but I want something that's a little brighter. Well, now you can look at my list and find out that, oh, this Yamaha trombone is, you know, pretty close, but just a little bit brighter. Let me try that one. That's the idea. So again, if there are trombones you want to see on this list, comment. And so we have the tone quality. For me, the King 2B is the brightest. That's pretty obvious. It's also the smallest. Bach 42 is the darkest. It's the largest. Those things go hand in hand. The BAC is right in the middle, and I'll explain a little bit why, and this is going to be a recurring theme. The King 2B has a lightweight metal, and the Bach 42 has a heavy metal. That's the rose brass, right? And the BAC has a yellow brass, which is a heavier metal as well. And so what we have here is a small, for with the BAC, a small bore horn, so a small tube with a heavy metal. And so that's why it kind of ends up in the middle on a lot of these lists, because the small tube is going to make it bright and the heavy metal is going to make it dark. Now, I would imagine you're going to find something very similar with a large bore trombone, which would make it dark, and a lightweight metal like a zinc or a nickel, and that would make it bright. And so those are where you find these more versatile horns, but for me, I don't like those as much. I like a horn to be, very far on one side or the other. So that's why I have a King 2B all the way on the bright side and a Bach 42 all the way on the dark. I like those horns. Okay, moving on. We have style and versatility. On the one hand, we have orchestral horns. On the other hand, we have lead, jazz, pop horns, and in the middle, crossover. The crossover horns are equally good or bad at doing one or the other. And so that's why the P-bone's kind of in the middle. I don't think it's really great orchestral or lead playing. So it's kind of, not really great at either. The BAC is a little bit better at the jazz pop scene than orchestral. So that's why it's on that side. The other two, pretty self-explanatory. Next, we have projection and response. Now, I originally had these as two different graphs, but I ended up with the exact same graph. And if you'll notice, it's pretty much the exact same graph as the tone quality. And so we're going to keep an eye on that, and it might actually end up being all three of those, projection, response, and tone quality, if those all go hand in hand. And I kind of show this as the weight of the metal. And so, again, the focus laser tone, that crystal clear, fast response, all of that stuff. When I talk about response, I'm talking about how fast the horn vibrates when you buzz, how quickly it responds to what you're trying to make it do. And so the King 2B I find to be, this crazy fast, crazy focused sound. And then the Bach 42 is a slower response, and it gets this super warm and dynamic and this giant sound, right? And then again, like I was saying, the BAC is right there in the middle. Now, P-Bone, I don't really know what to do with this, because it's not really focused and it's not really dynamic, so it's on there. I might just have to take the P-Bone off some of these because it doesn't really make sense. Next, we have effort. This is how easy it is to just kind of blow through the horn. If the air just feels like it's going through the horn and making sound on the way out, that's an easy horn. And then a laborious horn is one that you really have to, focus and try to make it sound good. That's kind of the difference for me between like a student model and a professional. A student model, you can make it sound great, but boy, does it take a lot of effort. So King 2B, I find most effortless, although the Bach 42 is right there with it. The BAC, for my tastes, because it's that kind of hybrid horn that's a heavy metal and a small bore horn, basically, if I want to play something, beautiful, then I have to try really hard to make this small bore horn do it. And if I want to play something that's, bright and jazzy, I have to make this heavy metal do it. So that's why that one's, normal. That's what a normal trombone will do. I find the King 2B and the Bach 42 being so far on each end of the spectrum, actually pretty effortless to play. Now, these ones, I'm sure you guys are going to have all sorts of comments about. This is, you're thinking this depends on the player and the mouthpiece. And I would say you're right. But this is my best interpretation of what the horn itself can do. So if you get a really great player who can play all of these notes, and sure, you could figure it out by practicing, right? And figuring out how to make each horn do it. I find that this is the top of the range you can play and not have it kind of be distorted. So more effortless playing to get to the top of the range of the instrument and what it sounds like. And so we have the P-bone. If you play that high B flat, that's pretty much as high as I would recommend going. Maybe you can play a C. Sure, you can play higher, but I think for what you want it to sound like, the high B flat is it. For the Bach 42, this gorgeous high F, that's pretty much as high as I would go there. I've certainly played higher. I've certainly played higher for you guys, but that's you know, the stereotypical sound of a trombone, that's where I would want it. That's where it still sounds like a Bach 42. The BAC, I find you could get a little bit higher. You could get to the high G, maybe an A flat. And then the King 2B, I really haven't found that threshold on normal notes. And so I put it at a B flat. I think you get much higher and it's squeal territory. So now we have the low range cutoff. The P bone again has the smallest range, and everything else goes in the opposite order. So the P bone, that low F at the bottom of the slide, the BAC, the octave below that pedal F, sounds pretty great. King 2B, you can go all the way out to seventh position and get that E. And the Bach 42, you got an F attachment. And I think if you got a great player who knows how to play the horn, you can get all the way down to the pedal C. All right, loudness cutoff. This is how loud you can actually make the horn go without it distorting, or without it, you know, stopping that vibration or sounding weird, or you know, distortion basically. And if we look left to right, you actually see the weight of the metal increasing, and I don't think that's any accident. The P bone has the lightest weight. It's plastic, right? King 2B, you got just kind of a I would call it a lightweight brass. I'm not really sure what the exact component makeup is. The BAC is the yellow brass, and the Bach 42 rose brass. So that's they're getting heavier as you go. And what I found is they have a higher limit for how, you know, hard you can make it blow. And so that's where I found, and I really think the Bach 42, virtually no limit. I mean, it can get loud and it doesn't really distort. Now, if you'll notice, the softness cutoff is exactly the same map. And so we'll keep an eye on this one as well, because I found as the metal gets heavier, I can actually get softer than I can with a lightweight metal. I thought this was going to be the opposite. And so this was my first, you know, really big surprise. And we'll see if it holds up. I'm not sure that it will. But I found I could get much softer on the Bach 42 than I could the small bore horns. And maybe that's what we're looking at too. Maybe it's that the bore size is smaller, and that's why, and not necessarily the density of the metal. We'll see. But that's why we're doing this. And so, the official unscientific Christopher Bill rating, we have the P-bone coming in not quite all the way on the sad side of this scale, because I've certainly played trombones that are not as good as this P-bone. And that's saying something. It should be the worst trombone I've ever played. It's a plastic trombone. It's not trying to be a trombone that plays really well. And yet, I've played trombones that I don't like as much as the P-bone. I've played trombones where I think I would rather be playing that plastic trombone than this. And so it's not all the way in. I really enjoy playing a P-bone. Now, right in the middle, you got the BAC. I would certainly rather play that than the P-bone. And the Bach 42, I would rather play than the BAC. And the King 2B is my favorite trombone. Now, I will say, I played a bunch of trombones when I was at the American Trombone Workshop. And I found a horn that I liked better than the Bach 42. And I found a horn that I like better than the King 2B. And so those two will soon, I hope, be unseated. But we'll see. Definitely comment with horns you want to see on here. I'll reach out to the manufacturers. We'll make it happen. I'm going out to the International Trombone Festival again this year. I'm leading the Youth Trombone Workshop, and so I'll be back there with all the manufacturers again with all of these trombones available. And so it's up to you to decide which trombones you want to see me play. I will also be uploading a kind of test where I play the exact same thing on each of these horns. And that's less for you to compare. I mean, you can, but it's more for me to be able to go back and listen to these excerpts and remember what it felt like to play it and remember what it sounds like in the room. And these are going to be unedited audio, super, super dry, because if you think about it, it's not even what you would hear in the room. In the room, you'd hear, you know, the vibration of the sound off the walls, and the microphone so close to the horn that you're not even hearing that. You're hearing the dry, you know, just what the trombone sounds like. And so, and that's what we want. And so basically it'll be a way for me to go back and listen and be like, okay, I remember that whatever this new trombone is, feels kind of like the King 2B. Let me see, does it respond a little better or worse? And I can kind of go back and listen and place these things a little bit more accurately. So keep an eye out for those. I'll post one for the BAC, the 42, and the King 2B, maybe even the P-Bone if I'm feeling fancy. So thank you for watching. Comment. I hope you liked this. And if you did, and you have questions about certain things about these trombones, like the metals or the bore sizes or any of that stuff, if you think this is all BS because it just depends on the mouthpiece, comment with that too. And I will see you guys very soon. Big thank you to the Patreon donors for making all these videos possible. I certainly could not do this kind of thing even just a year ago with all of my corporate rules and contracts. So this is going to be a fun new addition. I have an album. It's called Half Man, Half Machine. It's available on iTunes, Spotify, and Google Play. That sounds a little something like this.